Wad lo jabat mama, why? Wad lo jabat papa, why? Wad lo jibye mawe, why? Sase kana sovai. Wad lo jabat mama.
As Emancipation Day gets closer, the sounds of ancestral history booms in the atmosphere, rekindling a consciousness of a nation, calling one to embrace their African identity. The series of activities making up Emancipation celebrations, which are being hosted by the CDF, seeks to educate St. Lucians on their history and culture.
One of the things that we often do not acknowledge in a lot of St. Lucian and Caribbean history is the place of Africa within it. That all history begins in Africa. We as Africans began in Southern Africa and in Eastern Africa. We then populated the whole planet, moving into Europe and then into the Americas.
Dr. Dalphinis outlined the influences which formed the raw aspect of Kweyol. He believes that St. Lucians should indulge themselves in the understanding of linguistic roots and continue speaking the Creole.
You have, with the French, the people from Senegal and Gambia, the Wolof and Mandinka in St. Lucia, the Angolans who brought Kikongo and Umbundu, as well as the Evefon. Even their title shows you the kind of multi-ethnicity that the Eve are mainly people of Yoruba origins, and the Fon are people mainly of Ghanaian origins. It was a multi-ethnic state.
As a cultural activist, Dr. Dalphinis is grateful that St. Lucia gained independence. While there were internal forces trying to erase the Creole language, it should be used as a tool to recall the tales of the forefathers and as a means of free communication in the modern era. He highlighted the national icons who used the Creole language in their works and spoke proudly of the history attached to it.
As far as independence is concerned, we brought with it a capacity to express ourselves more openly in Creole. Our Nobel laureates continue the same theme. Walcott wants the Creole as part of cultural expression. So he tells us openly, "Moi c'est Jean St.lucia, c'est là moi sorti." So he identifies, although his main, if you like, means of communication is English.
Dr. Dalphinis hopes in the near future that Kweyol will become an integral part of the school syllabus, since it is an official language and not just a fad. He encourages citizens to also do extensive research on historical events to better understand their identity. For the DBS News World, Manasa Stanislaus reporting.